And all we did was look at Dutch angles for goddamn sake.
Andrew's
other... Graham, your new gimbal is broken.
I'm offending your British viewers. I'm offending your British viewers.
I'm offending your British viewers.
It's exactly 7:30 in the morning, and we are gathering the caravan to get ready to go down to Child's Play charity dinner. Isn't that right, Penelope? She says,
Morning.
Good morning. We're on the boat, and we made our time just perfectly enough that we could stop and get a coffee on the way to the boat.
The weather's very choppy, and it's, the boat, there it goes. The boat is, is real bumpy right now. We're in the gift shop.
Ah, yes. Real Canadian artists, like Adele and the Beatles. We are across, we're at the Tsawwassen Ferry Terminal. Now we have to make it to Peace Arch, cross the border, and get down to Bellevue before the snow happens. Because there's supposed to, originally there was a winter storm warning for today, which is real exciting, but they downgraded it. The National Weather Service was like, it's not gonna be that bad, but it's still gonna be some snow, probably. And so we want to get into Bellevue before the snow happens, because the I-5 and the 405 suck anyway. No need to be on it while there's snow. Also, we have a Kelly with us. Because there's a Penelope back there as well. And so Kelly will be assisting with the Penelope times. Quick gas station pit stop for water and Starbucks double shots because we're all tired and thirsty. But it is a gorgeous day today. The mountains have snow and they look amazing and the sun is out and it's a very nice trip so far. We should be at Bellevue in about an hour. Of course, our Airbnb host didn't mention until after I'd made the booking that the building was under some amount of construction. But they won't be doing construction at night, of course. And here's the place, which he said would be unlocked. That feels weird. Yup. This sure is an Airbnb. Keys. Perfect. Dang. Scenic views of the butt side of a mall, the biggest Winnebago I've ever seen, and a balcony that's under construction. All right. It's gonna do the job. This is fine. On the heels of two excellent Airbnb places, this place is like really not great. It's decorated like
a college house in that nothing matches. And everything's kind of filthy and in some cases broken.
Where are you from?
Victoria.
Oh, very nice. Thanks a lot, you guys. Enjoy your stay.
Thank you. How's my tie?
Looks good.
Good, let's do it. There's this amazing thing about Desert Bus at the charity dinner, and they updated the total to show our lifetime fundraising total. And that's so awesome. But they didn't read the body copy and it says we've been doing it for 5 years.
2007, the last 5 years.
I mean, we've been doing great for 5 years.
I'm not a math wizard, I'll give you that, but that's not right.
I'm no math surgeon. Can I say, by the way, I'm so mad that I didn't think to do this with the Desert Bus penny arcade pin in the lapel. Why is yours through the lapel and not the buttonhole?
Because I just fixed it right now. I still need to fix it again. Because I fucked it up the first time. Because I'm not an intelligent human being. Slash, I spent half an hour waiting for two other people to get ready and got slightly impatient.
James also remembered to wear his pin.
Must be nice. Must be nice. So, what improvements have you made to the charity dinner this year?
Well, I think you can see them behind me. There's some twinkle trees.
I do like the twinkle trees.
We have twinkle trees. We also have, for desserts, Yes. A s'mores bar with hot buttered rum shots.
Hot buttered rum shots?
Yes, yes. We have a waffle bar with a full array of savory and sweet.
Team Desert Bus is real keen on these waffles.
Yeah. Savory and sweet condiments for your waffle.
Awesome.
And a hot cocoa bar. Yes.
I didn't even know that was a thing.
I didn't know either. Until
I didn't know a
it was on the menu for the main bar.
Why had they not called it a smorgasbord?
I will tell them.
All right.
Yes.
Good.
Yes.
Pass that feedback on.
Which it should be.
Hi.
Where you at? It's at $1,000.
I'm out. How are you?
What's up?
Were you guys in a bidding war?
For a little bit, yeah.
Yeah.
Just get a highlight. But now it's at $1,000, and that's just no.
And then James.
No, it's at $1,000. I'm out.
I was upping him by $100, and then James is like, I got you, but 10. What's up?
Just get normal magic cards.
I don't want to. I have normal magic cards. What if I 50?
All right.
I'm so stoked to get my magic cards.
$1,050. That's probably my limit.
You can take all the magic cards.
No. Yeah. I will split it with you. I get the foil sheet. You can have everything else.
No. Okay. Here's the deal.
Split the foil sheet down the middle.
Here's the thing.
No.
I get the uncut foil sheet, and I'm pretty sure by all the other magic cards will open, we can build your own foil sheet for you.
Do it.
With scotch tape.
Do it. Go.
Sorry?
This needs to go higher.
There's a lot of people who are like, let's spend thousands of dollars on this. And there's a lot of people who are related to them who are like, please don't.
So this has never happened at the charity dinner before. I got given Feed Them hats.
That person came to me and I said, could you give them to me after the event?
Yeah, so I got them here. There's a hat from Homicide Life on the Street. This is a hat from the Tower of Terror at Disneyland. And then there's a mortarboard. I've never had them from here before, but now I have these hats. Hey, Kathleen.
Yeah.
What do you think of the AT-AT rocking horse?
It's very cute.
Yeah.
No, I've seen it.
It's right there, but there's people in the way.
It looks kind of unsafe for a very small child.
It actually does look kind of unsafe. It looks sweet, but like...
If we're going to get Penelope rocking horse, I'd like to get her a padded one, and she is one.
Yeah.
She's gonna fall off.
No, you just
That's
make
fair.
A pillow fort on the floor.
You make, you have to get runners that go all the way around that you can sit inside so you can just roll forward constantly.
Bubble wrap! Ooh, yep. There's leftover bubble wrap.
You're suggesting we put Penelope and the rocking horse in a Zorb.
Yeah, essentially, yes. Yeah. Put her in something that's like around like a hamster ball. Or as Ashley has suggested, wrap her in bubble wrap, like nice and firm, and just hope she can breathe, I guess.
How we doing, Serge? How we doing?
I'm so stressed. I think I'm winning, but I don't want to hover, and I don't want to care. But now that I'm winning, I care. It's really stressful.
5 minutes left.
Shit, 5 minutes! I need to, like, walk around the building, and then do I check again?
You can, like, drift past. Actually, you're 134?
Yeah.
I'll go check for you.
Oh, thanks, man.
You're still winning. So just keep an eye on it. Yes.
I think I'm happy. Okay.
Keep an eye on it.
Okay. I'm gonna put it on my ceiling and look at it before I fall asleep at night.
Yeah.
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 Right over the bed. Just good night.
I think Beach is camping the Yarn Yoshi amiibo, and I'm not really sure why.
Did you get the thing you wanted?
Absolutely not.
Oh.
I bid 30.
Uh-huh.
Got outbid. Of course I did. I went back. Somebody bid up to 60. So I'm like, okay, 65. And I stood there and waited. And a guy walked up eventually, and he went down, he wrote down a thing. I'm like, so I waited until he left. And I went, snuck up once he was gone. I'm like, let's have a look. $90. Yeah, I'm out.
Yeah. Well, is this just an amiibo?
No. No, this is for a Warcraft Doomhammer power bank.
Oh, that is cool.
I was going to give that away as a gift. And it had a watch and everything as well.
Nice.
And I was like, I will give this as a gift. But now it is $90, and I don't feel like spending that on a gift for somebody.
Fair enough.
The amiibo is straight from Japan.
Oh.
It's $60 now. Oh. And I'm like, I could just order it from Japan for $25. Because that's the spirit of the Child's Play charity auction.
Thank you all very much for your participation. And if you would please move over across the other side to take a place for dinner.
This really is this where you do the human pyramid?
Yeah.
Alright.
We ready?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Desert bus can raised.
Wow.
Someone went onto the website and was like, I like a round number, and donated just enough to take it up to an even $6.95.
And then somebody again, $10.
Another $10 just to mess it all up. When it says this on the sign over there, when we started this 10 years ago in a living room, we certainly didn't expect this, but we didn't expect very much at all. And it's been amazing to, now we have all these people and more people who couldn't be here tonight, who put this whole thing together, and it's amazing. Yep. And thank you all so much for all of the support that you give us to do this weird thing. We're so happy that we get to give you this crazy novelty check.
Wow. Well, on behalf of Child's Play and all of our donors and supporters, thank you guys so much. This is amazing. Woo!
It's you only. At 26. It's you.
So
yeah.
Yes.
That's not. That wasn't my money.
Send me a date.
It's a business expense.
What a business to be in.
Fight your neighbors with it. See
you're no longer into this?
Probably not. No, because this would be my money. It's a great point from Kathleen. Where would we put it? There's probably space in Penelope's room.
So what we've got here is some sort of caramel suppository, as I remember 80s sitcoms. Some people are drizzling them on top, but I'm pretty sure that what you're supposed to do is actually inject it in stratas throughout the rice pudding so that you have a caramel surprise as you spoon through your rice pudding, which contains, by the way, forbidden rice.
Hey, speaking of vlogs, this fine gentleman was watching the Japan vlogs where I was lamenting my inability to find a specific item on our trip to Akihabara, and here is a tiny tachikoma. Look at it! Look at the tachikoma! Ah, it's articulated as well. Thank you so much.
Yeah, no problem. And that's yours?
This is going to go on my desk at home. That's delightful. Thank you. Hey, Kate, what's up? Oh, is the waffle bar open?
The waffle bar is open. The hot chocolate bar with booze is open. And the s'more bar also just opened. I have a little strawberries with Nutella and hot chocolate with Bailey's and marshmallows. This is the best charity dinner ever.
Let's go get boozy hot chocolate.
Yes.
This gentleman, wait, what's your real name?
Nick.
Nick. This is Nick. And Scott G, the username.
Yes.
Right?
Yeah.
And was involved, won some stuff at Desert Bus, was around for Desert Bus, certainly. And earlier in the evening, gave me those hats that we talked about. It was a homicide hat and the Tower of Terror and a mortarboard. At the end of the auction here, in which Jerry was wearing a ridiculous reindeer hat, someone in the audience, was that you?
Yeah.
Someone in the audience was like, auction the hat.
Oh, no, that was not me.
Okay.
Sorry.
Okay. No. Someone in the audience was like, auction off the hat. This guy won that auction. I don't recall. How much?
It was $600.
For $600 for this hat. One moment.
I didn't win the nose, though.
That's okay.
Yeah.
Which he has now given to us for feed dump. This is by far the most expensive hat that we will have ever had on feed dump. So thank you, Nick.
You're welcome.
For this $600, it's almost a luchador reindeer hat. That's amazing. Cheers.
It's recording.
Oh, hi.
I don't know.
James has 1 minute.
Question for the ladies.
Sorry, Gabe. We're just waiting for two people.
The most important.
This feels wrong.
No,
yeah.
Look to the left.
Look to the left.
Yes.
Yeah.
You gotta get the arm really tight. I don't want to hit you in the face. Yeah. The other thing.
I don't understand what we just did.
Like dead center.
Apparently we all had to dab.
I know what to say.
So we dabbed. It's like, Tally, it's like if you have a cold, if you have a cold, to prevent from coughing and sneezing on people.
Oh, the sneeze into your elbow?
Into the elbow.
Oh, it's like what my nurse friend told me.
Exactly like that.
I didn't know those dance moves.
Except you also at the same time try to like smack whoever's behind you.
So it's like, you sneeze and then you share.
Yeah.
Learned something here today.
Dab. Thank you, Mac. Okay, so here's a question we were just talking about in there. What series of decisions led to this hat being made? It's like a star on. It's like a luchador
it's
mask.
It's like almost a luchador mask, it's but they're like, I got bored. Let's just put antlers on it, and it's a Christmas hat.
Did it,
like, maybe they ran out of the material for here,
did
and
they,
they're just like, let's just, oh, I have these antlers.
Did they make it as, like, a cap with, the chin guard, and it didn't sell? And then they were like, well, it's already red and green. What if we put yeah. ears and antlers on it?
And it's now Christmas it's themes.
Wrestling reindeer? What? How did this be? Right?
Yeah.
It's not comfortable.
It's kind of comfy. Chin strap makes it feel secure. Like
yeah.
I can go like, oh yeah, that's not coming off.
No, you can really like get
yeah,
in there.
I can like just like, oh yeah.
Yeah, no,
it's not
good.
Going anywhere.
It's good.
Love it. Wait. Oh yeah. I can be like the hockey player. I can feel Jerry permeating my scalp. It's gross. Everybody's laughing on planet Earth. That's just a lie. That is just a false. That's a falsehood. That tag is just a complete lie. Most people are weeping.
Hi there. I've got two things.
Okay.
I've got a silent auction and a live auction.
What's your number?
132. Grand start.
Oh, hey, G.
Hi.
Hey, what's up?
I was like, who's saying?
What did you win?
I got the full sheet.
Yes, you did.
Awesome.
I may have won a foil sheet, and I didn't know this, but like, also all of this product. Like, what am I gonna do with all of this?
Crack it for value and sell it?
Yeah, something. That is really, really
wow. That
really
is
pretty.
Even more gorgeous up close.
Oh man.
Oh boy.
It is silky smooth.
Oh, and of course the actual.
Oh, that's really, really cool, Graham. All right, let's not make this poor man hold this forever.
Yeah. Well, I have to pay them for it.
Like, it's insane.
So how much did this go for?
Me too.
I can't remember.
What was the total?
25?
26.
26? This thing is so pretty.
Like you can see the inlay, the cross-hatching here. It's gorgeous. It's,
yeah.
It's incredible.
Were you one of the ones that, like, last second?
That was me, yeah.
That was Graham.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
Are you bidding on this as well?
Yeah, yeah. I was the one that was winning it.
Oh, no!
This is something we hadn't considered.
Yeah.
Surge won this, the uncut sheet, which is this huge tube.
The tube would be fine.
The tube would be okay, but it's also this box of product. And I have this Crokinole unpackaged. Is there no box for it?
I don't think so.
I'm gonna see if there's a box for this thing. There's gotta be some sort of packaging for that thing. It's just, I don't want to transport it in a car trunk, just unprotected. It's also amazing. It's even more gorgeous up close and so smooth. So smooth. Wormwood does good stuff. And I'm not just saying that because they sponsor our AFK streams. Though this will be a funny AFK stream when it's like, we're playing with the Wormwood board. Also get free shipping if you're in the state. The Crokinole board. Did it come packaged in any way? Is there any sort of box or padding? He seems to know what's up.
Did you?
That looks like
an idea. Yeah,
okay.
That gentleman.
Oh yeah. One of the enforcers was like, hang on, and walked away. And I don't know where he went, but he looked like he had a plan. Oh, thank God.
Oh, great. There's also materials inside.
Oh, terrific. Okay.
Much better.
Awesome. Well, I was like, I didn't want to just be like, well, let's put this in the car. So.
Step into the roof.
All right, sweet. All right, we have a lot of bubble wrap. We'll figure something out.
A lot of that.
Hey, team.
Yeah, no.
Oh, my God.
Do you have any suggestions? This.
Oh, my shit.
Crokinole?
Yeah.
I just need to know how to play it.
So, real quick, you get these little wooden chits. You put them on this zone around the outside, and you just flick it with your wrist like this, and you get different points depending on if you get it in this indentation, or here, or here, or here, and you can knock other people's ones out of the way.
So it's a combination of shovel bird and curling.
Exactly. It's exactly like that.
It's painfully Canadian.
It's super Canadian.
And
yeah.
And then, yeah.
Nice. This is why we've enlisted the head of Desert Bus Shipping.
Is there anything at the bottom of that box?
Yeah, there's a bubble wrap down there.
Perfect.
Yeah, that fits real snug.
And then...
You've got a lot more bubble wrap.
Yep, that goes in the sides.
Ah,
it's
hello.
look, we're, who has it? Was it Tiesto or Avicii here?
Oh, yeah, no, no.
No, Deadmau5.
It was Deadmau5. We're Deadmau5 at fucking...
I'm Deadmau5.
Oh, no, Deadmau5 at fucking Dota. God, that broke me so hard when it happened originally.
This is cumbersome enough.
This is all my loot, turns out. I'm taking it back to Nanaimo.
This one person could carry.
I want nothing. I'm just, I'm a mule.
Western Canadian Crokinole mule. It is not a common species, but it is a rare and valuable species that is highly prized among collectors.
Okay, let's go.
One person could carry this, except that they shouldn't.
And is that your hat too?
No, that's.
Yeah.
Wait, who?
We can take the hat.
Hang on. You know what? We can turn this sideways. Are you
it's
sure?
Fine.
Okay. You got it?
It's really not heavy.
Okay.
That's ours.
See you guys later.
See you, James. I know you went to sleep. You should come to brunch.
Hello.
Boy, is it ever snowing.
Not very much, though. It's not sticking to the road, unfortunately.
Yeah. Hi there. It's going all right, how are you? Yeah. It's the morning. Man, I did a lot of talking last night. My voice is really... really wrecked, actually. It snowed a lot, and then it all went away. So we were worried about traffic conditions this morning, and it turns out that it's actually fine in most places, certainly here. And in fact, basically everywhere south of Bellingham is fine. So now we're gonna go into Ballard and have a big old brunch with everybody, because you know what we like is brunch. Because we're from Canada, we like brunch. Well, Victoria, anyway, loves its brunch. Oops, it looks like we're going. All right, how would we rate that Airbnb?
Well, it was absolutely a warm, dry place to sleep.
It certainly was warm, yes.
Finding a glue stick inside my comforter was weird.
That, yeah, inside the lining with no apparent point of ingress.
Yeah.
That was unusual.
Yeah, I would say that it was absolutely functional, but like, that I felt like I was staying in like a hastily cleared out like college dorm room with like, or like first
mismatched furniture.
Like, and nothing was super clean.
No, some of the chairs around the dining room table were broken.
Two of the chairs around the dining
room. Yeah.
50% of the chairs around the dining room table were broken.
Solidly half.
Like, there was like space for like six lights in the bathroom and vanity area, and there was, it's not that four were burnt out, it's there was only two bulbs. There's one bulb per bank. That's annoying. I would have liked to see.
Yeah. Because table saw in the front hall closet.
There was a table saw?
Yeah. I just closed the closet. I was like, nope. Just gonna leave it.
Also, telling us about the construction on the day of check-in, like as part of the check-in instructions, that's a little sketchy. I went back and looked at the photos, and the photos do correctly illustrate all the furniture that's actually there. You just can't tell how ruined it is. Which, yeah, that definitely says college dorm to me. Like, oh, this place looks great. And then you take a step in and you're like, oh, you found this all on the road. We're at the High Life in Ballard. Is it the, it's the High Life, correct? Used to be a fire station. There's like big fire station doors and stuff. But now it's a restaurant for people who like kale.
I ordered the special Walla Walla Benny. It's got like sausage patties and apple and herb hollandaise sauce. It sounds incredibly rich. I almost got a croque-madame.
I decided that I would go for the twofer. I'm getting a croque-madame, but I'm also getting a Belgian waffle, because I haven't had enough waffles. Even though I had a full waffle last night at the party, I've d- decided I haven't had enough waffles. I fell asleep in the car. Kelly fell asleep in the car. Penelope fell asleep in the car. So it was just Kathleen driving from miles and miles. And that's not fun.
That's what the Dear Prudence podcast is for.
Yeah, she was listening to podcasts. So now we need coffee. Starbucks is doing a Pokemon thing?
Yeah.
What do you... So you buy...
Look at the sports stuff.
What? Hang on. That's so weird. It's a Frappuccino?
No.
On December 10th? No. There's snow outside. No wonder it hasn't been... She said it hadn't been popular.
I don't want a Frappuccino and I like Pokemon.
It's very pretty here as a... roadside strip mall with a Starbucks. What else is here? Domino's, Ace Hardware, a spa called Massage Envy. Oh, they have an REI. It's like an MEC, but from America. I got a chestnut praline latte, which... I know what a chestnut is. I don't really know what a praline? I don't really know what that is, but it's tasty.
Caramel sugar, it's got pecans in it, and you like
ooh,
make
pecans,
a sugar.
Ooh, pecans, all right.
Crack candy kind of thing.
Okay,
usually
sweet.
In little circles. It's really Louisiana, down south sort of thing.
And Kelly got a peppermint mocha.
Okay.
We're just stretching our legs.
Well, we hit the Canadian border, and it snows immediately. Welcome to Canada, it's a joke.
We made the drive and the border crossing in enough time to make the 5 o'clock ferry. So now we're just waiting at Tsawwassen Quay, which is full of stuff that I never want to buy.
I want it here though.
Yeah, I mean I'll get like snacks here, but there's a lot of stores that sell like...
Tat.
Yeah, sunglasses, cell phone cases, like... RC quadcopters. Is that your phone?
Yeah.
Is it okay?
Oh, it's fine.
Oh yeah, lots of Pokemon around here. Kelly just caught her first Ditto.
Ditto! I'm super excited.
Regarding my decision to get a waffle and a Croque Madame from the High Life for brunch, what's the opposite of regret? Feel pretty good about it. Let's go get on a boat. It's really windy and cold. Let's go get on a boat.
Ugh. Just a little bitey.
Yeah, that's nippy.
Mm.
Ugh, indeed. I agree with you. It's a really long drive. Well, it's not a really long drive. It's like 2.5 hours from Seattle to the ferry terminal and then 1.5 hours on the ferry and then like 1/2 hour in from the ferry. It feels pretty long. It was basically the whole day. We went and had brunch and then just getting home. Penelope's exhausted, understandably, but still travels very well. We're very lucky in that regard. So Kathleen's dealing with her, and I'm unloading the car.
Hey,
Now it's rolling.
Hi, my name is Graham Stark. This is a G-Vlog from the Maiden Bauer Center. We haven't done these in several months, but I figured it was about time to actually do a vlog. Thank you so much. And now I have a
recorded a lot of stuff in Australia.
Like, I don't know if
also,
this
also, like, different ones for about moving, but I haven't edited them yet.
I don't know if this is looking at him, but editing is really an easy job. Like, a monkey can do it. Like,
oh, yeah.
Adobe Premiere just does it for you.
Yeah, it's basically,
like, it's fine.
Basically autopilot.
This is also like when he'd cut in a shitty song. Thank you so much.
Yes, have a good night.
Thank you. Like the this would be
that's
like, I'm doing my shot and the acrobatic music would come in and he'd just be like behind me talking about it and dancing behind it. And that'd be a vlog in Desert Bus.